right now at Cranmore Fitness.
All right, and welcome back to White Mountains Today. We have M&D Productions in the form of Ken Martin and Karen Gustafson.
Cool.
Good thing I'm not on stage,
it's
right?
Okay. Okay.
I would have blown that line totally. So sorry about that, Karen,
okay.
But good morning to you both.
Good morning.
So M&D Productions, we just visited with you guys, and so amazed. I mean, I've seen productions there, high quality theater, but to see the whole thing behind the scenes was amazing, a woodworking shop and where, you know, the actors and actresses hang out and your hangout spot. Let's talk about that because this is like date night prime right here.
It is. I mean, we have the what we call the Culture Cafe downstairs of our lobby, our main lobby when you come in. And we encourage people to come hang out before the show and after the show, have a couple cocktails,
right, and you have
a glass
like
of wine.
Tables for two set up,
we
and
do.
It's very cool. In the month of February, as you mentioned, the month of love.
It is the month of love.
Wonderful. And M&D Productions, you guys never slow down. Now, Karen, what do you handle at M&D Productions?
I do just about anything that needs to be done. I'm a volunteer, and we're always looking for more volunteers. So if anybody's out there and wants to get involved, everything from set construction to
right.
helping with concessions, whatever. I'm the volunteer coordinator. I'm a
Great.
Board member.
And it takes
and
a lot of people.
Sometimes I get on stage a little bit, too.
Oh, do
that's
you?
Fun.
Great.
So it's just a fun place to do a lot of different things.
What's your favorite thing to do as a volunteer?
Oh, I don't think I can answer that.
Yeah.
As a volunteer?
It's
just
great.
Whatever the immediate need is. It's my favorite thing to do
thing.
At that moment.
Well,
that's a diplomatic answer.
Right. Well, I think another thing that surprised me is how many productions you guys put on and how quickly you turn it over. Because you're doing Love Letters now. That's a couple-day production. So you're doing that on the 13th and 14th, which is Friday and Saturday. Let's start there. What's this all about, Love Letters?
Love Letters is by A.R. Gurney, who, if you're familiar with his work, he also wrote Sylvia, which is a fabulously funny story about a talking dog. but this is not like that. This follows the path of two people throughout the course of their life from second grade, I believe, mm-hmm. all the way up to current time, mm. exchanging letters back and forth, corresponding with each other in the written word,
right.
which is kind of a dying
it's
art.
It's rare. It's rare nowadays. And sometimes, you know, the people are texting and they're typing and stuff. You go to write and you're like this. Mm. So this is a collection of their lifelong letters to each other. Now, this was a romantically involved couple?
Yes.
Yeah.
At times.
We'll say
that.
Yeah.
Because I'm sure
they definitely had a relationship throughout mm-hmm. their time together via letters and in person.
Oh. Okay.
I don't want to give too much away.
Right.
It's Melissa and Andrew, and it's kind of an up and down thing. A lot of heartwarming moments, mm. some comedy, and an ending that you'll have to come see what happens.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
And how long does the play last?
Yeah, that's a good question.
I think it's about 70, 75 minutes. It's not a full-length two-hour production.
Mm-hmm.
So if you're looking for something, you know, in and out, go to dinner afterwards,
yeah.
you know, make it an evening of romance. We're offering complimentary champagne. Chocolates.
What? Complimentary champagne.
Yeah.
Can I just go hang out? Get some theater, get some champagne. Be very festive for
sure.
Valentine's Day.
It will.
Perfect timing.
All right, so that's the 13th and 14th. How do they get tickets?
They can get them by calling our phone at 603-733-5275 or visit us on the web at yourtheatre.com.
All right, so that's easy. It's a great website, and you can check out not only the current production, but what's coming up on the calendar, because as I mentioned, you guys never slow down. So you turn this around now, and then The Last of the Red Hot Lovers.
That's right,
comes
the
in.
Neil Simon comedy.
Now, you guys have already practiced this, and you're already cracking up, so
we're
that
in
bodes
rehearsal.
Well.
It's a very, very funny play. It's one of Neil Simon's better plays. Mm. He's a very incredible writer, if you've seen any of his work.
But I don't know if I have. What else would I have
California
seen?
Suite, Plaza Suite.
Odd Couple?
Yeah, the Odd Couple.
I gotta get out more. I gotta come hang out with you guys, maybe do some volunteering myself, and get my
Absolutely.
Husband to do a little theater
yeah.
production. And you guys are constantly looking for actors and actresses.
All the time.
Are they always musicals, or does it depend?
No, most of our plays are not musicals. We tend to do fewer musicals than most theaters.
Mm-hmm.
We do one or two musicals a year, but the rest of them are dramas or comedies.
Great. And so everybody can get involved, whether you're a woodworker, you know, set designer, or costumes. You guys have full costumes as well. And then the actors and actresses, always looking for local talent.
Yeah.
So Last of the Red Hot Lovers, I didn't mean to interrupt you. It's a comedy.
Right.
Can you give me sort of a general
There's this man named Barney. He's in his late 40s. He's going through that men's midlife crisis, and he's trying to discover the passion in his life again. And he sets up dates. He's a married man. He sets up dates with three different women.
Oh.
And he
How
takes them to his mom's apartment.
How does his wife feel about this?
Probably
does
not very
know?
Happy
yeah.
if she knew.
Is this on the sly?
It is all on the sly. It's set in the late 60s. He's, you know, the last of the love generation.
Sure. Kind of there.
And it doesn't go well for poor Barney.
Well,
he meets
I
some very
that.
Interesting women.
Oh, I bet. Now, Karen, what's your part in this production?
I'm actually in Love Letters. I'm playing the part of Melissa.
You are?
And Rich Russo is playing Andrew.
Wonderful. So and now, are you going to be in the Last of the Red Hot Lovers as well?
No, that's already all set.
Okay, so it's all casted for this one.
Yep.
And that starts soon, February 19th, right after Love Letters.
Yep.
Right, and it plays Thursday, Friday, Saturdays, and Sundays for 2 weekends only.
Fantastic. All right, so March 1st, and then what do you guys go into?
Well, we also have the Oscar party in February, on February
22nd. Of course 22nd. You do.
Yeah, you know, because February wasn't full enough.
Right. You guys drink a lot of coffee, don't you?
Yeah,
just a little bit.
Right. No. So what's the Oscar party all about?
Alec Kerr from the Call Me Daily Sun hosts our Oscar party. This is the fifth? I think it's the fifth annual.
Sounds good. Ooh, fifth or sixth.
That he's hosted for us. And what we did was we watched the Oscar show live, and then during the commercial breaks, Alec does some trivia about the movies, and we just have fun with the audience. And we have two separate areas where you can watch the show.
Great.
The rowdy room and the quiet room.
Oh, good.
And there's food involved.
There is.
What kind of food are we talking, Karen?
Donated by Marcello's, Vito Marcello's.
Ooh, yeah.
Bellini's.
Tasty.
Bellini's.
Yes.
Okay,
yeah.
Bellini's the old name, sorry.
Right. No, yeah, that's fantastic.
And, you know, full bar if you want to have a drink to go with
How
it.
Do we get in on this?
So,
is it already booked?
It is not.
No.
Tickets are available.
Yeah.
Call now.
And the price is $15 per person?
$15 per person.
And that includes food or is food addition?
Food. Yes, it does. The
you
drinks are not included, but the food is.
The drinks aren't included, but the food, come on.
But you can't even go out to dinner for $15.
It starts at 7 o'clock.
Okay.
It goes till the Academy Awards
are
over.
What do people wear?
We encourage people to come as dressed as they like or not undressed as they like, but dressed down, casual. But if you want to come as a character from one of the nominated plays or movies, please do. That would be great.
Oh, wow. Okay.
There's no dress code. Come
all right.
however you wish.
Wonderful. And what's the date on that? Sorry, again.
22nd.
That's on the 22nd.
I'm making notes now. And what time does it start?
Sunday? 7 o'clock.
7 o'clock. Okay. And they can find out more on your website at yourtheaterre.com as well as giving the theater a call.
Correct.
Okay, so recap. We have Love Letters going on Friday and Saturday, 13th and 14th. Karen's a part of that. Well, you're both a part of everything. But then after that, Last of the Red Hot Lovers, Neil Simon, February 19th through March 1st. Mm-hmm. And then Oscar Party, don't forget, on the 22nd. And then do we dare look ahead one
We're
more
We're not going to go any further than that.
I don't know how much time you have.
I think that's a lot.
As you heard on the story report, I can just go on and on. Well, thank you so much, both of
you.
For, one, bringing great theater to the Valley and for coming on this morning. I know it's an early morning for the theater people at night when you're putting on productions.
It is when you're up till 10:30, 11 o'clock,
goodness, go get them. All right, thanks again. M&D Productions, you can find it at Willow Place Mall. They're right on Route 16 on the right heading north. It's the yellow place, and you get right in there. M&D is on the left-hand side as you drive in.